guys, it's Molly. Welcome back to my channel. I am doing a little vlog with you guys today, and it's on my phone because I forgot to bring my camera with me, so sorry for that. But I decided that I wanted to go to Barnes & Noble and just kind of see if there's any like new releases or anything that I'm interested in, and just have a little me day. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm currently at the gas station, just filled up St. Clair. He was a little hungry. Now he's full, so we're good. I just got vaccinated too. Where's my little, here we are. Just got my first dose, so that's cool. My arm's a little sore right now, that's all. So we love that for me. I'm gonna find a Dunkin' and get some coffee, maybe like a donut or something, because I'm a little hungry. I was gonna go to get breakfast, but I don't wanna go eat breakfast by myself. So I'm not gonna do that. So I'm gonna get Dunkin' and then we're gonna drive to Barnes & Noble, so let's go. Okay, currently in the drive-thru, just ordered my Dunkin'. It's a little bit of a line. So I'm going to read a little bit. The book that I'm currently reading right now is a reread, if I can get it out of my purse, and that's Birthday Girl by Penelope Douglas. Oh my god, I loved this book so much the first time I read it, and lately, I don't know, I've just been like thinking about Pike, and I really just wanted to reread this story because Pike is literally one of the best book boyfriends of all time. Like, I have not found anybody, I mean, there's book boyfriends that I love, but he is top mother tier, okay? Like, he is amazing. $100 on books? Yes. Do I regret it? Let me get back to you on that. I got a lot of books that Gabby has talked about from Gabby Reads, and some that Katie from Katie Colson has talked about. So let me just do a quick little haul. The first boring book that's not really a book that I'm just gonna get out of the way is just this dot grid journal that I got because I want to do a reading journal, and it was only $7, so picked this up. Hopefully it's good. I don't know, it was $7. Okay, the first like actual book I got was My Sister the Serial Killer. I actually don't know if Gabby read this, but I'm pretty sure she's mentioned it, or I made that up, I don't really know. Oh shit, my book just no, I don't know if I did that or if I just looked at the book bad. Whatever, books are going to get ruined. Anyway, this is by a Black author. Her name is Oyin. I'm going to pronounce this so wrong, and I'm so sorry. Oyinkan Braithwaite. I'm so sorry. I know I pronounced that wrong. I'm very excited to read this book. It was $14.95. For anybody who's wondering, the font is a good size. So, you know, I'm ready for it. I'm very excited to read that. The next book I know Gabby has talked about, and that is The Echo Wife by Sarah Gailey. I really wanted to get this in a paperback, but they only had the hard copy book, so homegirl paid $25 for this. But it was the only one they had, and I really wanted to read it. It sounds very interesting. Basically, it's about this girl who made a like clone or like replica of her, and then the clone and replica like starts sleeping with her husband. Talk about drama. So yeah, I'm really excited to read this book. Font is a good size. It's this really pretty yellow color on the inside. The actual like book doesn't have anything like special on it. Yeah, I'm really excited to read this book. The next I got because of Katie, even though the author is being a little problematic right now, it is The One by John Mars. I think Gabby has also talked about this book, but I really like the premise of it. Basically, there's like this DNA test that can tell you who your perfect like match is, and there's like, you know, problems with that because what if the person you're with currently isn't the person that your DNA matched with, you know what I mean? So I don't know, it seems very interesting, and it looks like it follows a few different perspectives. So I'm really excited to read this, although John Mars is being a little weird commenting on Katie's video or her Instagram post with the laugh cry emoji. Okay. Next I got Wilder Girls by Rory Power. I got this from Katie's recommendation. Not sure if Gabby has read it or not. But this, from what I remember, it's basically like there's this it's a school, and then there's a sickness that goes through, and it's infecting like the teachers. I don't really remember more that much about it, but yeah. Oh, and this actually has bonus content. It has map, a deleted scene, discussion questions, and editor author review. Where's the map? Oh, just kidding. It was in the front like I thought it was. So apparently this is a map of Raxter Island. I don't know. Apparently that's probably where the school is. I don't know, but excited to read that. And last, this is from Gabby's recommendation. It is Dancing at the Pity Party, a dead mom graphic memoir by Tyler Fetter. Oh my god, Gabby said this made her bawl her freaking eyes out, and I just like did like a little like one of these in there. And first of all, it's so gorgeous, like the illustrations. There's a lot of words on the pages. I know I'm gonna cry because I'm really, really, really close with my mom. Like, she is literally my best friend. She is my go-to person. I go to her for everything. I just fucking love my mom, okay? So I know that I'm going to bawl my fucking eyes out when I read this book, and I'm not ready. I think about sometimes, you know, what's gonna happen when she's not here someday, and oh my god. So that's everything I got at Barnes & Noble, and while I'm up here, I think I'm gonna go to Five Below and see if they have any cute, like, decorations, because I really want to, like, make my room cuter, so I think I might stop over there. I'm gonna sit here for a second, eat some more of my Dunkin' and drink my drink, and yeah, hopefully I don't spend as much money at Five Below, because I just spent $100 here. Just leaving Five Below now. $80 later. Oh my gosh, I literally need to stop spending money today. I'm done. So I'm gonna eat my bagel. Yum. There are a few little free libraries around where I am. I've never been to these ones before, so I have a bunch of books with me that I keep in my car in case I go somewhere that has free little libraries around me. So I think I'm going to check out a few of them while I'm up here. It's only 11:30, so I have like the whole day to go. So, yeah, I'm going to check out a few of those and eat my bagel. Wow, I'm so washed out right now. Here we go. So now we're going to head to those little free libraries. So now I need to use my phone to be my GPS because I have no idea. I mean, I know where I am, but I don't know, like, where these are. So we're going to go search them. All right, guys, first little free library. Thank you. one of the little free libraries that I went to, like, one of the ladies was, like, working outside right by it, so I didn't stop because I have social anxiety. The last one that I just went to was a dud. I've got a few more that I want to go to. Two more, I think. Maybe possibly three. So let's go to those and see what we've got. Y'all, I was just driving and I had my next free little library, like, in the GPS. And I just found this one when on my way, so I'm going to stop and check this one out. Plus, it's a rainbow. How cute. Okay, let's go look. I just want to show you guys quickly the four books that I got at the little free libraries. One of the ones was The Martian by Andy Weir. I'm not really sure how to pronounce such name, but I think that I remember Katie Coulson talking about this, or I'm making that up. I don't really know, but from what I know, what this is from the back, it's about this astronaut named Mark Watney, and he's one of the first few people to walk on Mars, and then he thinks he's gonna be the first person to die on Mars too, because a dust storm happens, everybody leaves him, so the rest of his force leaves him on Mars, thinking that he is dead. So he's alone on Mars, I think. I don't really know, I've never read anything like this. Apparently it's soon to be a major motion picture starring Matt Damon. Don't know if it already is or not. Please comment down below if it already is, as I'm not sure. But yeah, this is science. It says science sci-fi. Never read anything in that genre, so this will be interesting to check out. Then I got James Patterson and Gabrielle Charbonnet, Witch and Wizard. Never heard this either. It is a mass market paperback. It looks brand new. If not brand new, maybe read once, because the spine does have a little bit of a crack in it. And from what I got from the back of this, it's about a brother and sister, and the world is changing. The government has seized control of literally everything about society, and people are disappearing, and the brother and sister find out that they have, like, they're a witch and a wizard, and they have powers, and yeah, that's all I really gathered from the back of this. I don't know what it is. I've been trying a lot of James Patterson books lately, or at least getting a lot of James Patterson books, so we'll see how this is. Next, I got Hotel Ruby by Suzanne Young. Never read this either. Never even heard of this, actually. I have heard of her other books. The Treatment, The Program, The Remedy, The Epidemic. I've heard of them, but I've never read them. I've seen them on Book Outlet, actually. I think this is like a thriller. Something about this girl goes to stay at this hotel. I honestly don't know. I don't know, but I saw it and it looked kind of interesting, so we'll give it a shot. And then the last book is I'd Know You Anywhere by Laura Lippman. I love how this is like holographic. And it is blurbed by Stephen King. Stephen King says, the best suspense novel of the year. When did this come out? In 2010. Wow, my cat farted and it smells so bad. Anyway, this, from what I got is there's this guy was, he kidnapped and held this girl hostage for almost 6 weeks. And now he's on death row for the rape and murder of his final victim. Apparently now he wants forgiveness. It is like a worn copy. Like it does have water damage, which I don't mind. I love getting like older books that are like this. I don't know what it is, guys. It just makes me like, you know that it's been read, you know it's been through some things, and I don't know. I really like that. So I'm interested in checking that out. I'm also thinking of doing a reading vlog where I exclusively read books that I've gotten from Little Free Library. So let me know if that's something that sounds interesting to you guys, because I do have other books that I got from Little Free Libraries besides these four, obviously. If you go watch my Little Free Library vlog, which I'll have linked up in the cards and in the description box, you can see what books I got from there too. But definitely let me know if that sounds interesting to you guys, because I will definitely do that video.